Yes, the title is correct, and no, it is not clickbait. In fact, there are many incredible things that your body does to protect you from disease. And there's even something that you can do that has an astonishing heart attack protecting effect. It's truly incredible. It's called cardiac preconditioning. So, what is it? How does it happen? How can you give yourself more heart attacks to prevent heart attacks? Did you ever expect to hear those words strung together? We need to start at the heart attack. There are different forms of heart attack, but the most common is ischemic, meaning your coronary arteries of the heart are somehow blocked and there's no blood flow reaching the downstream sections of the heart. This lack of nutrients and oxygen ultimately leads your heart cells to die. And if that happens on a mass scale, you ain't gonna be upright for much longer. Now, the reason I call cardiac preconditioning incredible is because it's a technique by which you can reduce the future heart attack size by 40% or more. That's the difference between death and life, the difference between being hobbled for life and a normal life. The first ever study on this phenomenon dating back to the 1980s, the researchers showed, as we can see here, that a heart that was preconditioned had a 4 times smaller heart attack than the hearts that were not preconditioned. There are some added nuances that we'll get into in this particular data later, but for now, just know that preconditioning the heart protects massively when an actual heart attack occurs. Okay, so what is preconditioning? Preconditioning is putting the heart in a situation that is very similar to a heart attack. Essentially, it's a short period of ischemia, as defined earlier in the heart attack, that creates lasting protection if a person experiences a true heart attack. Fascinatingly, this effect has been demonstrated in, according to these researchers, in mouse, rat, guinea pig, rabbit, dog, pig, and indirectly in humans as well. There's a strong consistency across species. Okay, so what exactly happens to your heart? Then, what can you do to cause cardiac preconditioning in your own heart? First, some of the mechanisms, and then we'll rely on this scientific review for clarity. For one, there are many extracellular, that means outside the cell, signals that affect your heart cells, from adenosine molecules to catecholamines like epinephrine and several other molecules. They bind to their individual receptors, which activates a grouping of key proteins called phospholipases. These phospholipases, they're enzymes, convert molecules of PIP2 to IP3 and DAG molecules. Now, you don't need to remember all the names, just that there's a cascade of events that happens inside the cell. From there, DAGs activate a master protein called PKC. This PKC protein activates further downstream proteins called transcription factors, which translocate or move to the nucleus of your cells and bind specific genes that contain the genetic information for proteins that will protect your heart cells if serious ischemia occurs. For example, one such protein is BCL2. If your cells incur too much cellular stress, they can undergo cell death called apoptosis. This is partly mediated by a family of proteins called the BCL family proteins. Some encourage apoptosis and some block it. BCL2 blocks it. So, preconditioning increases the concentration of BCL2 in the heart muscle cells, protecting them from a cell death fate. Or, another protein that is produced is called iNOS, which is an enzyme responsible for the generation of nitric oxide. This nitric oxide opens blood vessels and allows more blood flow through, a critical factor when there's a blockage stopping blood flow. So if you're interested, I'll be covering more on the mechanisms, including mitochondrial ones, in the extended version of this video, included for the Physionic Insiders. It's linked in the description. Now, while this has been shown experimentally by literally clamping blood vessels and starving the heart in different animal models, we aren't about to reach into our chest and clamp our arteries. So, what else can be done to increase cardiac preconditioning? And there's an important caveat that we have to keep in mind that I'll get into in a minute too. If we pop open this review, the researchers indicate that while the mechanisms are slightly different, cardiac preconditioning can occur through exercise. Unfortunately, there hasn't been enough research on the types of exercise to get into much of the details. However, it seems clear that aerobic endurance exercise is likely the primary way of inducing this cardioprotection. In fact, there have been some preclinical data that also indicate high-intensity interval training could offer this cardiac preconditioning benefit. These researchers even point out that there's strong evidence pointing to people who exercise regularly are more likely to survive heart attacks. This might be one of the major mechanisms for that, although it doesn't exclude other factors. As for the caveat, it's in relation to this data that we went over. This was measured 40 minutes after the heart attack happened, meaning if the heart attack can be resolved in 40 minutes, there's a significant reduction in the overall damage due to preconditioning. However, when researchers do this same experiment and wait longer to resolve, as seen here, there's no protective effect. The time frame for that experiment was 3 hours. This was an animal model, so we don't know if this carries over to humans in those exact numbers, but it offers a glimpse that cardiac preconditioning isn't a forever protection. Still, even a 40-minute window could be a massive one when discussing potentially fatal heart attacks. Oh, also, one more fascinating piece. It's believed that the heart conditioning effects could extend up to 72 hours. So, for example, exercising and then having this cardiac preconditioning effect lasts for days after exercise. So imagine if you exercise every day or every other day. That means constant protection. Powerful stuff. That all is due to changes called late cardiac preconditioning. Again, mechanisms that I'll be discussing in the extended version of this video for the Physionic Insiders. At any rate, heart health is critical, and I cover so much more in this video right here. I'll speak with you over there. Thanks for tuning in.